It's crispy to drama boy.
Oh, Erima. Oh, Erima. Erima.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Mercy. Thank you so much for joining us. If you're new, make sure you hit that subscribe button and turn on your notification bell so you'll know whenever I upload. Okay, thank you. All right, so let's just get started. I'm using my Suns Out Buns Out palette. This palette was sent to me by Chantilly Cosmetics. If I'm saying it wrong, I'm really, really sorry. But they were happy to send me their palette. As you can see, it's very, very pigmented. Their matte shades blew me away, like they were so pretty. And then we're just gonna grab the Magic by Juvia's Place, and we're taking that orange at the top row right there and placing it in that same exact area and blending those two together. So you're gonna see me going back and forth with these brushes just to make sure that there's an easy, simple, clean transition between the two shades, one to deepen and then the other brush to buff out everything together. Blend, blend, blend. All right, so now we're just gonna cut the crease. I'm using my Makeup Revolution concealer in C5. This is my favorite concealer to cut my crease with, and I finally picked up some crown brushes. I don't know the names of them right now, but I will list them down below. These were recommended to me by Beauty by Melissa on Instagram. She always uses them to cut people's creases, and y'all know she's queen bee when it comes to this stuff. But I really do believe these brushes are amazing. I used it and it was amazing. And you guys, I actually sew down an area here. You guys are gonna see, I wanted you to see how much concentration it takes for me to cut my crease. Like, I don't blink, I don't breathe. Like, this is a crucial moment in my life, in my career. Like, take your time. If you want that crease to be sharp and precise, just take your time. This is like the longest process in this whole entire makeup routine, is cutting the crease. So just take your time, make sure everything is good, and then just take a small buffing brush and blend that out so it doesn't look too harsh and weird, you know what I'm saying? So let's go back to the Magic palette by Juvia's Place, and we're grabbing that neon pinkish floral color. Floral? What is, that's not even a color. Stop. And we're just going to put it in our mobile eyelid right there. It's very pigmented and I love the shade. I loved it so much. Like, it's almost neon. It's almost neon. That's how bright it was. So just place that on your lid and then grab that pinkish champagne-y color at the top row there and just place that in the middle and then just blend it out together. As you can see on my other lid, it's supposed to look like a reflection, like, you know, the sun is doing its thing on my lids or whatever. So that was what I was going for. I know right now it didn't look like it in the other eye, but take your time, blend it out. I used about 3 brushes in this process because I was making sure the edges are blended nicely, the colors are meshing together. Okay, take your time. Take your time. And then I realized that something was missing. Like, I didn't want it to just be like this bright orange slash pink color. So I just deepened the creases and I added a deep purple in my creases and I blended it out. I wasn't gonna do that. That's why it looks weird that I'm not even close to the camera or anything, because that wasn't even in the plan, but I just pressed record just in case, and voila, it turned out great. And you'll see throughout the video, you'll see me darkening it and everything like that, because I wasn't really sure about it, but you know. And then now it's time to do the little sunset reflection thingy. So I'm just using duo glue, the green one with the brush, and then I'm using a very precise brush to place that loose pigment. That's a pigment from Cake Your Face on Instagram. It's supposed to be a highlighter, and because it's so finely milled, I decided to use it as liner in this case, and then just like place it right where you cut the crease and everything like that. Just take your time, okay? This look is so beautiful, but I really did take my time, you guys. You guys are seeing the fastened version, of course, but I really do take my time when I'm doing these type of looks because I need them to be beautiful. I need those lids to look the same, you know what I'm saying? So yeah, take your time and everything like that. So I'm just wiping off any fallout because we're getting ready to start the base. This is my favorite part. I love doing my foundation and concealer and everything. Like, eyeshadow is good, but I just love me my foundation routine, okay? And then pop on your lashes and let's get into it. So I'm grabbing my L'Oreal Glow Lock Primer. You know, guys, this is like one of my favorite primers that I own. So I'm just using that. I haven't used it in a minute. I had forgotten how pretty this primer is. And can we please just take a moment to appreciate how bomb my skin looks. Like, my skin looks so bomb. I'm so happy. Thank you, Jesus. But anyways, grab your ColourPop concealer. I mean, sorry, your ColourPop No Filter Foundation. I use 175, dark 175, and dark 180. And look at how beautiful. I told y'all in my video, if you haven't watched my foundations video that I recommend for women of color, I'm gonna link it right up here so you can see. You guys know I have never used these foundations on my channel, so I wanted to show you guys that I wasn't lying when I said these foundations are bomb, and they're only $12. Like, look at how beautiful that is. Like, ColourPop did that, okay? And it's so, like, full coverage too. Like, I had forgotten how full coverage it was. Anyway, grab your concealer. I'm using the LA Girl Pro Conceal in Fawn. And I'm just placing that where I usually place it, right in my T-zone there, under my eyes and everything like that. And then blend that out, making sure that all the edges are blended and diffused nicely and everything. I just love this routine. Like, my routine is so bomb. Like, y'all don't understand. I love it. Because I take my time and I make sure everything is blended. Then I make sure that the makeup looks skin-like. That's always the goal for me, is that my makeup looks skin-like, okay? And then grab the ColourPop No Filter Concealer. I'm using dark 40 for this one. I just wanted a little bit more brightness, so I just added just a little bit, not too much, so we don't have cakey. We don't want a cakey face, okay? And then I didn't show you guys, but I've used this concealer. I used it in my last video before my foundations video. If you haven't seen it, I'm gonna link it up here. But it's a Sephora concealer. It's called Devil's Food. That's the shade. It's so bomb. As you can see, it's very creamy, very blendable. You just have to be, like, you know, good with the wrist or whatever, but blend it out, buff it out. Those are my two favorite things to do in life, is to blend and buff. Blend it out and buff it out. Make sure that there's no harsh lines. You don't want a harsh contour, sis. We don't do that over here. And then I'm grabbing my newfound favorite setting powder, Luscious by Lynn. This is a no shine translucent powder. I love this stuff. Do you see how it just melts into your skin? Yo, I'm not even joking when I tell y'all, from the day that I got these powders, I have not touched my Sasha Buttercup. And you guys know Sasha Buttercup is everything to me. This powder has replaced Sasha Buttercup for now. Like, Sasha Buttercup has retired until further notice, okay? So put that all over your face, under your eyes, and anywhere else that I put concealer, that's where I'm putting all the powder. And then now it's time to set our contours while I'm using my Contour Station notebook by the crayon case. Just making sure to buff that out nicely. Yes, sis. Look at my skin, y'all. Oh my god, yes. I'm telling you, I'm in love with my foundation routine. Y'all don't understand. And then grab your Juvia's Place, the Saharan Volume 1 Blush Palette. And I'm using that, the color I pointed to, just to bronze up my face. Look at how, like, beautiful that came out. Oh my god. Okay, so then now I'm just using this, you see this blending brush right here? I mean, blending sponge, or, you know, beauty sponge. This is from Sigma. They sent that to me, and y'all, everybody needs that. If you guys want that brush, you can get 10% off or 20% off if you use code MERCYM at checkout. Telling y'all need that. You guys saw how easy it was for me to chisel out my cheekbones. Y'all need that freaking beauty blender, okay? Go get it. Use my code. So now we're gonna go back to the eyes. I'm using that dark purple shade to put under my eyes. Obviously, you guys know I like a smoky under eye. So all the colors we use at the top, I'm just gonna use at the bottom and make sure that it's nice and blended. And then now I'm grabbing my Sigma Longwear Eyeliner Pencil. This pencil, do you see how dark it is? Y'all, I thought my Urban Decay one was dark. Like, for some reason, every time I buy eyeliner now, it's just getting better and better. Thank you, Sigma, for sending me that, because that eyeliner is beautiful. Look at that. Sis, you out here killing it. So you guys know I have to open up my eyes somehow, so I'm going back to the Magic palette, and I'm grabbing that color. It's like an iridescent purple slash lavender slash lilac slash silver. I don't even know. That color is so beautiful. Oh my gosh. Like, look at that. It just brought the look together, okay? So now it's time to set and forget, okay? The reason why I do this is to cover, like, I cover the eyes just in case it gets too much on the eyes, and I like a more saturated, like, feel when I'm setting my face with a setting spray on my face instead of my eyes. So that's why I did that. It's not a big deal. You don't have to do that. You can if you want to. It doesn't matter. So now it's time to highlight. I'm going back to the Juvia's Place, the Heron Blush Volume 1 palette, and I'm grabbing that highlighter there. It's so pretty. Look at this highlighter. Like, it's so skin-like. It melts into your skin. I loved it. I love that highlighter so much. Love it, love it, love it. And put it all over your face, highest points of your face, your cheekbones, of course, and blend that out nicely. And I'm not only gonna use one highlighter. Y'all already know I have to layer my highlighter. So I'm going to pick up the Crayon Paste Rosy Glow Res Highlighter. It looks pink, but it's, yeah, exactly. It's gold. It's like this, like champagne gold highlighter. Oh my gosh. You guys know I love to layer my highlighters. Like, I can't leave the house without at least three highlighters on. So today I used these ones and I was feeling like a goddess or whatever. Okay.
Coming crazy. On the lover. Trying to run it, trying to run it. We're recovering. We don't cover it.
Lips, I'm just grabbing those two right there. I don't have them with me right now, but everything will be in the description box. I wanted a vampy look for this, okay? So I needed to do some crazy stuff, and that's why I used two liquid lipsticks. But other than that, after that, we're done, and you know, it's lit, girl. So make sure you comment, like, and subscribe. I'll see you on my next video.
Gucci, Prada, for my head, oh, baby, oh. And everything for my head, oh, baby. Yeah, yeah.